We have heard in the Gospel the account of the Last Supper, how Jesus instituted the Eucharist for us, giving Himself as our bread, as our food. Jesus has so lowered Himself. Although He was God, He became man, and an ordinary man, like a slave, and He became obedient unto death, death on the cross. But also, giving Himself to us as bread, as food, is part of His lowering Himself. While Jesus instituted this sacrament of giving Himself to us, the disciples in the same table were arguing among themselves who is the greatest. Yan pa ang concern ng mga disciples. Ang kanilang master nagpakababa na, and yet they were squabbling, fighting among themselves, sino ba ang mas dakila sa atin? Hindi yung amo, ngunit yung lingkod. Hindi yung pinagsisilbihan, ngunit yung nagsisilbi. And that is a good reminder for us priests. Our greatness is in the lowering of ourselves, in serving as servants. And one way of being a servant is being a steward. We are stewards of the mysteries of God. Yan po yung hawak natin. The steward is not the owner, but he has responsibilities which he will give an account of in front of the owner. Kaya madalas sa ating mga pare, saan may katungkulan sa simbahan, na mawala sa isip natin na tayo katiwala lang. Kasi mayroon tayong command. Mayroon tayong otoridad. Mayroon tayong tungkulin. Kaya madaling maging boss. Kasi ako yung masusunod. Pero dapat intindihin natin, may mas mataas pa na boss kaysa sa atin.
Jesus is there in the Blessed Sacrament, everybody to me. My dear brothers and sisters in the Eucharist, I am exceedingly edified that in this special occasion, we celebrate God's goodness and generosity for the gift of Eucharistic vocation in the congregation of the Blessed Sacrament. It is a great gift that God has graciously given in the service of His church and His people. It is a sacred and sublime gift that I am forever grateful to God for He calls and chooses me in spite of my limitations and shortcomings.
Ano bang ibig sabihin ng pagbibigay ng buhay? Parang malabo, masyadong general. Now, to make that more concrete, it means that we give our time to Him. Kasi ang buhay naman natin ay ang ating panahon, ang hawak natin. Is our time given for the service of God or baka atin lang yon? Hindi po tayo mga empleyado na may 8 oras ng paglilingkod. Tayo'y katiwala ng Diyos. Anytime we can be called. Mahalaga pong pag-isipan yan. Lalong-lalo na ngayong pandemic, ang dami nating oras, saan natin ginamit yan? At bahagi nga ng ating stewardship sa Panginoon ng ating oras, na sana huwag nating kalimutan ng isang pananagutan natin ay ang magdasal. We have the ministry of prayer. And hopefully we spend time to pray, and spending time to pray is not wasted time. We are not the owners of the Word of God. We are stewards of the Word of God. Therefore, we preach what God wants to say to His people. Are we sure whenever we preach that we are preaching God's Word? Or we're preaching our own idea? That's why it's important that we have to immerse ourselves into the Word of God so that we may get His Spirit and that we may bring to the people what God wants to tell His people. Passion for the Word and passion for the people, that we're able to connect the people to God's Word. Isa pa, we are ministers, we are stewards of the mysteries of God. Especially, we are stewards of the Eucharist. The Eucharist is not ours. It is God's gift to His people. But that Mass is not your Mass, it's the Mass of the Church. And the people have the right to a Catholic service, not to your service. That's why you have to be careful that the celebration that we do is the celebration of the Church, because we are just stewards of the Church. Hindi atin ito. We become great in our priesthood if we become servants. And our kind of servanthood is stewardship. May panunungkulan tayo, may kapangyarihan tayo, pero tayo'y mananagot sa may-ari. Hindi tayo ang may-ari. Stewardship of our time, stewardship of the Word of God, and stewardship of the Holy Eucharist.